that the world will come to know who he is.
Everybody's room, come on and clap your hands. Fill the room with worship. Amen.
It's not my worship that makes you worthy. God, you are always good. With or without my song, you're still holy. God, you are always good. And I can't help hallelujah, I've got to let it out. You've never needed my voice to cry holy, so I get to say you're good. With my whole heart, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. I get to sing it forever, louder I sing hallelujah.
or bow down and say you are God. Every man will bow down and say you are King. So let's start right now. Why would we wait? King of glory, fill this place. I just wanna be with you. Just wanna be with you, yes. King of glory, fill this place. I just wanna be with you.
Anybody wanna be there?
Just wanna be with you.
Stretch out your hands, come on. Yes, the world.
It's the world.
Bow down.
Bow down and say,
bow down and say you are King.
So let's start right now.
So let's start right now.
Why would we wait? When we can praise you right now. In victory.
In victory.
Say King of glory.
King of glory.
You. You, we magnify you, we glorify you, Lord, for you are King of Kings and your Lord of Lords. Father, thank you even now that it is by your great grace and your mercy that we're alive even now. Father, thank you for your mercies to us, dear Lord Jesus. Thank you for being merciful to us, Lord. Thank you for reminding us of your love even now, Lord. We ask of thee that your spirit will come right now in this room. Your Holy Spirit will be here right now. Father, thank you, dear Lord Jesus Christ, that it's not by might nor by power, but it's by your spirit. Father, we thank you, dear Lord Jesus Christ, that even now you're here. And we thank you, dear Lord, that you are the one that is about to do great and marvelous things in this house tonight. Father, have your own way. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, somebody, put your hands together for Jesus. Come on, somebody, put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. My God, I'm excited for what God is about to do. I have a funeral that I have to do, and so I'm going to do what God says to do and then take care of God's work after again. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Prophetess shares me and my family shares me. They're used to this. That's why you must always lift my family up in prayer. As my family gives 99% of their father and their husband, my wife's husband, which is myself. You know, people don't understand, you know, the mental strength you have to walk with a prophet of God. Notice I said a prophet of God, not a false prophet. A prophet of God. Amen. So, I'm excited for what God is about to do tonight because one thing I want you to understand is as we are here, we know the Lord Jesus is here. But one of the things I want you to understand is the importance of us being able to walk in the Spirit, not in accordance to your flesh. Because if you live in accordance to your flesh, then you will end up missing what God has in store for you. And the only way for you to be able to receive what he has for you is if you are moving in the Spirit. Amen. I don't hear people say amen. Amen. Because if you are not careful and you find yourself in a place where you become like the regular believers, the Christians, the religious-minded, traditional-minded people, then you will miss God. Because God is not a God of tradition. God is not a God of religion. Hallelujah. He has his traditional ways, but his traditional ways is unfathomable to the mind of man. If it was fathomable, then we would all be in one accord. Oh, Jesus. So therefore, there is traditional ways that God has, but his traditional ways is not ways that is fathomable to the mind of every human being. Meaning, his traditional ways is his goodness and his grace. His traditional ways is that he will be with us to the very end of time. His traditional ways is that we are always on his mind and he is always, you guys are not here. So it means that God has his traditional ways and his traditional ways is good. Jesus. It's the religiousness. That's the problem. And I've realized even today that a lot of people are religious minded, not spiritually filled with the Holy Ghost. It's a difference. If somebody is religious, they will believe, yes, God is real. Yes, we know the Lord Jesus Christ. But then they will demonize prophets. Yet God has still spoken to his prophets concerning his people, concerning his children. So that means God is still speaking. His traditional ways concerning prophets still exist today. He still speaks. Amos 3 verse 7. Surely the Lord God of hosts will do nothing until he reveals his secrets to his servants, the prophets. Meaning that anything that God wants to do within a city, within a state, within a providence, with who am I speaking to? Anything he's doing concerning a country, even the United States of America, he has sent a prophet to speak on his behalf. Who are you? Who am I speaking to? Am I speaking to Breakthrough Nation? Are you here? So I want you to understand something today. I want you to understand it is important for us to live in the spirit. The Bible says it is the flesh that lusts against the spirit and the spirit against the flesh. You have to understand, the Bible says it's the spirit that quickens, the flesh profits nothing. So if you are looking to feel good, you have missed it. You're still a baby Christian. But if you're at a place where you're saying, even though my flesh does not feel good, I know that something is happening right now. God is doing what he, who am I speaking to? I know for a fact, God is moving. Hallelujah. Go high five two people and tell them it is good to be in the house of the Lord. High five them. High five them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we here? Are we ready? Hallelujah. So let's look at Exodus 14, verse 11. Let's read Exodus 14, verse 11. And I promise we're going to be, we're going to take care of God's business. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God is here. And where the Spirit of God is, there is freedom. There is liberty. Liberty means what? Freedom. Meaning that you're free. Free to worship, free to praise. Free to, I thought people would have been excited tonight. You're not, don't quench my spirit. Don't quench the Holy Spirit, I should say. Hallelujah.
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 Okay, are we ready? Okay, let's look. Let's read Exodus 14, verse 11. Go ahead. After two, one, two.
And they said unto Moses, because there were no graves in Egypt, hast thou taken us away to die in the wilderness? Wherefore hast thou dealt thus with us to carry us forth out of Egypt?
One more time.
And they said unto Moses, because there were no graves in Egypt, hast thou taken us away to die in the wilderness? Wherefore hast thou dealt thus with us to carry us forth out of Egypt?
One more time.
And they said unto Moses, because there were no graves in Egypt, hast thou taken us away to die in the wilderness? Wherefore hast thou dealt thus with us to carry us forth out of Egypt?
Hallelujah.
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 You may be seated in
heavenly places.
You guys better act like it. Okay, I'm going to be quick. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So I wanted to understand something by the Spirit of God. And today we're going to be speaking about confidence. I was at Revelation last night and I was telling my family and the spiritual sons that were at my home, I was telling them, I said, boy, I got to piggyback off what Prophet Lo preached last night, because I was there and he was speaking about spiritual audacity. And one of the things you get to understand is, and I'm not a teacher as he is, but I do, we carry the same Holy Ghost, the same Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
So I want you guys to understand this by the Spirit of God. It is very important for us to be able to move in with confidence. And a lot of times as the children of God, we don't move in confidence and with confidence. We move from a place of fear because, hear me now, because we feel that just because we received a word from the prophet of God, from the Lord, we feel the need that just because we don't see anything manifesting the time we want, that we start to be fearful of what?
Come on, come on.
What's supposed to be said concerning us, well, what was said concerning us, and we're not seeing anything happening the way we wanted to. So then we become fearful.
Teach.
We become fearful to the point where you don't move in confidence.
Yes.
Because the truth of the matter is, whenever God has spoken to you concerning your life, concerning your destiny, concerning your finances, concerning your family, concerning your business, concerning your ministry, you have to understand it is something powerful. when the devil hears it and is mad.
Come on,
but
prophet.
The truth of the matter is, whenever you receive a prophetic word and what God is saying concerning your life, you have to understand it's one thing to receive it, but it's another thing to be confident that no matter what the storm may come, who am I talking to? That no matter what the storm may come, that you're able to be confident in God.
Come on. Hallelujah.
You're not hearing me. So hear me. Hear me by the Spirit of God. You have to be confident. And remember, confidence is not boldness. You can be bold to say something. You can be bold to stand up for what is right. You can be bold to stand here and say, I receive this word. But it's another thing to still be confident in the wilderness, no matter what is happening around you.
Yes.
You receive the word, you are healed, you are being restored. But it's another thing when you enter the wilderness after you have received the word.
Come on.
And you walk through the doors and you feel that same spirit of fear coming upon you, doubt and worry coming upon you. But it's another thing when you stand confident in God.
Come on.
You gotta be confident. The Israelites prayed to God for God to deliver them from a place where they were bound. Are we here? Yeah, it's AC on. I'm sweating. There must be the anointing. But hear me. Hear me. I only got a few minutes. Hear me. But one of the things we get to understand is this. Israel cries to God. God begins to speak through his servant Moses, and is telling Moses what to do to free Israel from being bound to Pharaoh. See, I'm taking you from that place of stagnation, but you're going to have to taste what it's like to be stagnant.
Yes. Come on.
I'm taking you from problems, but it doesn't mean you won't face them, because to triumph over the problem means to have the power over it.
Teach.
See, you can ask God to use you in the area of healing, but don't taste what sickness feels like.
Yes.
Look at you. Look at you. You can ask God to make you wealthy, but you have a problem being broke. Look at you.
Come on.
You're a father. I'm asking you that you will cause my name to be great. Well, you better be okay with your name being spat on.
Yes.
Look at you.
Teach.
You want to be great. You want to be famous. But it's another thing for you to be able to go through the testing. Oh, look at you. You have to go through trials and tribulation. But hear me. Israel looks and is saying, this is something I want you to understand. Moses, it would have been better. It would have been sure better if you were to leave us in Egypt to die. Listen to this. Let's look at verse 12 very quickly. Is not this the word that we did tell thee in Egypt, saying, let us alone that we may serve the Egyptians? See, the issue is, some of you, when you met the prophet, everything in your life started flipping upside down.
Teach.
That's what you thought. But the truth of the matter is, there was a demon in your life.
Come on.
That has been hiding in your life.
Yeah.
And when you met the prophet, an exposure came. Meaning.
Come on, prophet.
Meaning that when you find yourself where you have met the prophet of God, whatever has been hiding can't hide anymore.
You're teaching.
So when you say, well, ever since I met this prophet, my finances has dried up, my marriage is destroyed. The truth is, nothing was destroyed. Nothing was not. What happened is that the demon that has been hiding in your finances, hiding in your marriage, hiding in relationships.
Yes.
Who am I speaking to? The demon that has been playing games with you for over 12 years, 15 years, 20 years. Who am I talking to?
Come on.
That demon has been exposed.
Yeah.
Are we here? Israel is sitting. Israel is asking, wait. Did we not say, leave us alone in Egypt? We would have been better there.
But you are taking us to this place to die here. The Egyptians are coming after us. It would have been better. You left us there to die. I prophesy over your life today.
Prophesy.
That you are the head and not the tail.
I receive.
Prosperity is your portion.
I receive.
You shall not fail.
I receive.
You shall not be downcasted.
I receive.
But may God lift you and elevate you.
I receive.
May God raise you.
I receive.
May God lift you.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of
Jesus.
Hear me. Israel has a problem. Remember, Israel is still God's chosen people. Israel has a problem. The problem that Israel have is confidence. They're lacking confidence.
Come on.
See, the thing is, many of you are sitting here, you have received the word that God is about to elevate you.
Yes.
That God is about to increase you.
Come on.
That God is about to lift you up. That God is about to do great things. But the issue is, you lack confidence because you have forgotten what God has said concerning you.
Come on, prophet. Teach.
Confidence. Touch your neighbor and say, be confident in the Lord.
Be confident in the Lord.
Be confident in Him.
Be confident in Him.
Be confident in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Be confident in the Lord Jesus Christ.
It would have been better for you to have leave us to the Egyptians. At least we know we would have been good. Because it looks like, hear me, it looks like when you came to rescue us, which we have prayed to God to rescue us, it looks as if you have rescued us to die. But
come on,
if they had the confidence in God,
teach,
they would have foreseen.
Yes.
That even though they were set in a place where it looked as if nothing was going to happen.
Yes.
They would have seen that there would have been a way out.
Come on.
God is giving you a way out.
I receive.
The Lord has already given you a way out.
Receive.
A way out of stagnation. A way out of limitation. A way, who am I speaking to? A way out of generational curses.
Yeah.
A way out. That way is Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Listen to me. Listen to me. I have a few minutes. Listen to me. God is speaking. God told Moses, tell these ninjas. Tell them. Go speak to them. Remind them of my word. God is not a God that he should lie. God is speaking. Listen. Many of you, God has spoken to you concerning your life, spoken to you about your destiny. But the reason why you have lost confidence is because, watch this now, you have failed to understand. When you receive your prophetic word, somebody else heard.
Come on. Teaching, sir. Come on, prophet.
Look at you. Somebody else heard. You think the devil... The devil heard everything, Richie.
Yes.
Listen, let me tell you the truth. Some of you, you sit in churches, blind, bad people speaking to you. You have no insight and foresight. Listen to me. When every word you get from a prophet of God, or a word of, or whatever God has spoken concerning your life, the devil hears it.
Yes.
He does not know your future. That's why the Bible said he's the accuser of the brethren, meaning he only knows your past.
Come on.
The devil accuses you because he does not know anything about your future. He only knows about your past. Every word you have received prophetically by the Spirit of God, the devil heard it. If the devil has heard it, listen to me. If the devil has heard it, ask yourself one question. Who else is after me now?
Come on.
Some of you, you're looking at people around you, wondering, is this one? You have no idea. It's not the person. It's the spirit within them.
Yes.
Did not Jesus look at the Judas and say, no, go and do what you're supposed to do?
Come on.
It was then the spirit entered him. Some people.
Teach.
Some people, the reason why they're attacking you is because the devil heard the word and has entered them.
Come on.
Joshua, I'll just stop teaching.
Teach, prophet. But, go deeper.
But hear me. Look at this. It's not just the word that we did tell thee in Egypt, saying, let us alone that we may serve the Egyptians. For it had been better for us to serve the Egyptians than that we should die in the wilderness. Watch this now. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not. Stand still. Touch your neighbor and say, fear not.
Fear not.
Stand still.
Stand still.
Fear not.
Fear not.
If that neighbor is not speaking to you, go find another neighbor. Say, fear not.
Fear not.
Stand still.
Stand still.
Be confident.
Be confident.
Don't just be bold. Be confident.
Don't just be bold. Be confident.
Watch this. Watch this. Moses said to the people, fear ye not. Stand still. And see the salvation of the Lord, which he will shew to you today. For the Egyptians, whom ye have seen today, ye shall see them again no more. Some of you, you are going through the wilderness and you keep thinking, because the spirit of fear has entered you, you keep thinking that this is where it ends. I'm here to tell you today, this is not the end.
Come on.
Who am I speaking? Let me go and find somebody else. Who am I speaking to?
Speaking to me.
This is not the end.
Come on.
It's not the end.
Yes.
Fear not. It stands still. Stand to your feet. Who am I speaking to? This is not the end. Stand still.
Come
be
on.
Confident. Be bold. Know that what God has spoken to you is what he's saying today. Be confident. Who am I speaking to? Be confident.
Yes.
The devil, every word you ever say, the devil hears it. Some of you, you don't understand. Let me explain something to you. If you read the book of Daniel chapter 10, you get to understand. The Bible speaks about Daniel praying a certain prayer. And Archangel Gabriel came and took the word and is going back to deliver the word to God. And the Bible said that the prince of Persia,
come on,
came. As the king of Persia, came. Stopped him. And after stopping him, the Bible then says, Archangel Michael came. When Archangel Michael came to help him, to fight, Gabriel was able to go deliver the word. Gabriel came back, said to Daniel, from your heart was said to this thing, it was already done. Why is it, watch this now. Why is it Gabriel had an issue in the spirit? Because when Daniel opened his mouth, the devil heard. And the moment the devil heard, are we here?
Yes.
The moment the devil heard, there was a disruption in the spirit.
Yes.
There was a fight going on. Gabriel needed help. Because Gabriel was not, I don't know if you're ready for this kind of teaching. Gabriel was not strong enough.
Come on. You're teaching.
Gabriel was not strong enough of an angel as Archangel Michael was to fight.
Come on.
You see, we have to be careful when we teach, because carnal-minded, I like you.
Teach.
Are we here? Be confident. Let me explain something to you. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It looks rocky. It looks sticky.
It looks like every door is closed, but I'm here to prophesy over your life.
Prophesy.
Whatsoever you're seeking today and you've been praying for, God has already done it.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? I'm here to prophesy over your life to tell you today, God is still moving concerning your life. Whatever you have asked God for, it is already done.
Amen.
Look at you. Whatever you have asked God for, it is done.
Amen.
Stamp, sign, seal, delivered.
Hallelujah.
There's nothing to worry about. There's nothing to stress about. Nothing. Why? Because God has already done it. Are you hearing what I'm saying? God has a what? He has already done it. Be confident. Know that whatsoever God is about to do. You know, this is the issue today. We have forgotten who our God is. Because if you have not forgotten, then you would have never been in a place where you say, God, have you forgotten me? I've been waiting concerning this thing.
Come on.
I
prophesy. Go deep, sir.
You just said that. What do you see? You're bad. You don't share my secret code. What God has spoken concerning your life. Don, is that you? I'll miss you. Whatsoever God has spoken concerning your life, it is already done.
Amen.
What you don't understand is what you're going through right now. It's because there's an exercise that is happening concerning your confidence.
Come on.
See, it's one thing for you to have a house, and it's another thing for something to happen where all of a sudden the finances is dried up and you're wondering what is going on. It's another thing when you have been good financially, then all of a sudden you realize you can't pay for the car, you can't pay for anything. You're wondering, what's going on, God? Then you have to go and hold a mic and still preach the word. And look at you. Look at some of you.
Come on.
Some of you have not reached that part. It's another thing to come, clap your hands, give the Lord thanks, but yet you don't even know where the next plate of food is coming from. But when you have confidence in God,
yes,
you already know that even though I may walk outside of my house today,
yes,
with $0 in my account, I have confidence to know,
come on,
that within 20 seconds, my phone may go beep, beep, and I see 20 yes. million. That judge, who am I talking to?
Yes.
Money came to my account. I don't know where it came from.
Come
but
on.
I had confidence in God
yes.
that God would have done the impossible.
Come on.
Who am I speaking to? Are we here? So right now I want you to lift your voice to heaven. I want you to pray right now. I want you to say, Father, help me. Give me grace. Father, I thank you for spiritual audacity. Thank you, Lord, for confidence. My confidence is in you, Lord Jesus Christ. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Come on, lift your voice, lift your voice. Come on, lift your voice like thunder, like, come on, lift your voice. Lift your voice. Father, your word is a two-edged sword. Father, thank you that your word has entered my inner being, my spirit. Lift your voice and pray.
The rock on which I stand, and everything.
Father, thank you. Thank you for your confidence. Father, to be bold is not the same as being confident. Father, may I not be like Israel that forgot who you are. Father, thank you for your confidence. Spiritual audacity. Lift your voice, lift your voice. Come on, lift your voice. Come on, lift your voice. There's a change concerning the way you think that is happening right now. I'm here to tell you that no matter what it looks like, if you only could hold on just a little while or longer, if you could just hold on just a little while longer, that you will see the goodness of God, that you will see His mighty hand. Come on, lift your voice. Come on, somebody lift your voice. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It doesn't matter what it sounds like. If you could just be confident enough to know that God is about to do the impossible. There are doors that are about to be opened. I hear the Ashapadabokatadaba. Come on, lift your voice. Can I prophesy?
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody lift your voice and begin to pray. Father, help me. Father, give me grace.
Father, give me grace.
Father, give me confidence.
Father, give me confidence.
Father, thank you for spiritual audacity.
Father, thank you for spiritual audacity.
Father, thank you for what you're about to do concerning my life.
Father, thank you for what you're about to do concerning my life.
As you parted the Red Sea for Israel.
As you parted the Red Sea for Israel.
Father, thank you for parting everything for me.
Father, thank you for parting everything for me.
Father, your favor.
Father, your favor.
Father, I receive.
Father, I receive.
A double portion.
A double portion.
Of your favor.
Of your favor.
Of your grace.
Of your grace.
Father, thank you.
Father, thank you.
Father, thank you.
Father, thank you.
Lift your voice and begin to pray.
Father, I thank you for a double portion of your favor. Father, I thank you for a double portion of your grace.
Razula Bamba Baba 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 Le Rusa Patika Ramazunde Epea Rasi Patu Reke Parukata Razunde Elele Rabazu Andalaba Asikia Robo Soto Riata Lama Razi Telemanda Elos 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 Rabazunde Eke Parusta Robo Baba 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 Larissa Mando Robo Setili Makuraba Eturaba Zende Epelia Robobo Sandelaba City Maka Raziti Adu Sapa Robobo Sandi Aku Repeziki Razu Tama Zandarada Razu Alaba Ando Orosiki Rabi Sikiti Father, thank you for confidence. Father, thank you for boldness. Razi Mandaraba Sutea.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
I don't like that.
Can I get a shout of praise for the King of Glory? Open up your mouth and give God some praise. Hallelujah! 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 So So, Father, today we thank you for this word. We thank you for the word that gone forth that has allowed us to walk in confidence, that has allowed us to walk in freedom, that has allowed us to walk in liberty. Father, today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, if you're in this room, just lift your hands right now. Father, today in the name of Jesus Christ, as we depart from this place but not your presence, Father, may we not have only heard the word, but may we carry the word from today. May this word become a part of us that, Father, even as we are going through our daily lives, we are able to manifest this word of confidence. We are able to manifest it to our children, to our brothers, to our sisters, to our co-workers, that Father, from today we may become a beacon of light to those around us. And Father, we thank you for the movement of God that just took place in this room today, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen and amen. Right now, I just want you to grab what you want to give to God. Grab what you want to give to God and make sure that it is an offering that can attach to the word that was just preached, that you are able to receive something special from what God has done today. Uncle Milan, can you just put on something vibesy, something hype? Bring their offerings to the altar in praise and thanksgiving towards the Lord our God. Amen and amen and amen. Father, thank you so much to all, for all who have gave. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, touch your people. Touch them by your Holy Spirit today in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, whatever they gave, you know their hearts, you know their minds, you know what you placed in their spirit to give. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, cause a double portion of your blessing to rest upon them today in the name of Jesus. Cause your spirit to go forth with them that when they depart from this place, they are able to manifest your glory. They are able to manifest what you preach to them today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And Father, we thank you today for what you have done in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. Don't forget that Sunday service is coming up at 1:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And next Friday service is coming up 7:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time as well. Be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen.